Eat this shit up.
Historically, Houston has been a major player in hip-hop for a time period that stretches across several generations of rap fans. Going way back to the foundation of its culture with the founding of Rap-A-Lot Records and the coming of Suave House Records that created stars in hip-hop like Scarface, the Geto Boys, Tela, 8-Ball and MJG, along with others. Going on to the era that for the most part created the culture of Houston that thrived for decades. That being Screw, which brought about artists from several different independent record labels, which was a movement within itself, producing labels like Wreckshop Records, Swisha House, Screwed Up Records, Jam Down, Sucka Free, Chevis Entertainment, Game Face Entertainment, Boss Hogg Outlaws, and more. There were also a breakout success prior to the latter that gave Houston artists that had been in the underground a spotlight on Wanna Be a Baller by Lil Troy of Shortstop Records. And now the era that we're in now, with a wave of artists. A new wave of artists, some who have seemingly cracked the cheat code in artists like Travis Scott and breakout superstar Megan Thee Stallion that spent a short period of time in the underground before being discovered by 1501 and took flight. Kentheman, who was in the midst of ascending her career. Maxo Kream, Sauce Walka, Lil Jairmy, Tobe Nwigwe, OMB Bloodbath, Don Toliver, Monaleo, B King, Lil Guapo, DJ XO, and the list goes on and on. And although Houston has had a tremendous success in the music business with so much more to accomplish, there's been an extremely dark side attached to Houston that is centered around death that stained Houston and served as a dark cloud over the city for years. Drink has been a substance that's been celebrated in hip-hop. Unfortunately, as so many artists have exploited the substance and made buku money off its reputation, Houston suffered from it. Big Mo of Wreckshop Records was a super talented, charismatic artist that created timeless regional hits that positioned him on the Billboard chart several times. His voice was smooth as his charisma, with his rap singing delivery that seemed to be before his time as the industry is dominated by this particular sound today. He's lost his life through a combination of issues that left him in a coma. The presumed catalyst to these complications was syrup, which was a theme to a lot of his music. DJ Screw, who spearheaded the Screw era, was essentially just like others in that time who had a strong dependency on the substance, which is rumored to be the contributing reason behind his demise. Pimp C is another Houston-based artist that would eventually succumb to the same, although there are rumors that circulate around his death. Nevertheless, Drink was something that stunted Houston's growth. As much as it helped create an identity for the city's music scene, the deaths associated with also served as part of the culture. There are still artists from Houston in this generation that are big sippers, but some like Sauce Walka kicked his cup and went sober, possibly to avoid history being repeated. Some of the biggest and brightest talents Houston has ever had have died. Some to Drink, just as we mentioned, and others to the barrels of guns. On February 3rd, 1998, Fat Pat was killed, shot in what most call a misunderstanding after he was set up while picking up show money from a promoter at an apartment complex in Southwest Houston. He was a promising MC and some consider him to be the greatest rapper of all time to ever come out of Houston, but his life was cut short in the midst of that ascend. Nowhere near his full potential, or his biggest hits, or his biggest albums. His death, like others in Houston, stunned the city. Big Hawk was Fat Pat's brother. He was killed 8 years later, blocks away from Dead End, the hood that he helped popularize. And to this day, his death still hasn't been solved. Big Steve, Mr. 3-2, Chucky Trill, MG Santana, Matt Grace,
and Gator are all Houston artists that died horrific deaths. All of these deaths have been over the past 25 years, and all have jolted the community at the times of their reckoning. To a certain degree, it's almost like death was synonymous with Houston. It was eerie, almost like who was gonna go next. At a time when Houston had the potential to create mainstays in hip hop, deaths tore that dream apart. Artists with high potentials lost their mojo, probably not feeling the same with so many parts missing from the puzzle. Somehow, some continue to mash on and continue the journey with heavy hearts, with a dark cloud hanging over their heads. I'm sure other cities have similar stories, but there isn't one that strikes me with the same parallel as Houston. Like I said, for a long time, it was just odd. Almost like a curse. It's Hype South with Child Time TV. Until next time, peace.
Eat this shit up.